Good morning, welcome back to my channel. If you are a subscriber, thank you for coming back. And if you are new here, hello, my name is Crystal. I am now a fourth year first grade teacher, and today I get to come into my classroom to start setting up. Today is Friday, July 30th, and we are technically not required to be here today, and we can come in on next Monday and Tuesday for trainings, but the official start date is on the 4th on Wednesday, but I decided I won't really have enough time, so I will just take today and do most of my moving and arranging today. Past couple of days have been crazy. I had to move, and so I am just now newly situated into my new house, and it is just my third day in the new house, so it has been really crazy and very, very hectic. I apologize for not having a lot of teaching videos up, but I really did not have any time to do anything but move and pack. And so right now I am just going to go into my classroom. I have to pick up my keys. I will unload all the things that I have in my car, and then I'll see you when I get to my classroom. Oh, wow. We are in my classroom now, and it is looking a little bit different. If you saw my end of the year closing and cleaning my classroom video, then you know that everything was in this corner over here, and they said they weren't going to move everything just because it's a lot of stuff, which I was totally fine with, but they were able to move everything and then clean the carpets, so I'm super, super thankful. This room is looking as clean as I've ever seen it. Over there, all the computers are cleaned up, and it is super, super clean in here, so thank you to the custodians. They did such an amazing job in here, and I'm kind of wanting to move things around just because they did move everything. So I'm still gonna think about that. I don't really have any plans of that right now, but let me show you everything that I brought in from my car as well as everything that I was provided with. So here are the things that I brought in from my car. First, I brought my Cricut in. I moved, so I don't really have space for it, and I just use it for teaching. So this is gonna stay here, as well as the accessories that I need to use with it. I brought some crafts things. If you saw my summer haul, and if you haven't yet, go ahead and check it out, but I brought some things from there. And then my computer, because I do have class today. I started my master's program, and so I need my computer and also to use with my Cricut. I brought some lunch, of course, and then these are the things that I was provided with in my mailbox. So this year I got a bag full of some markers, sticky notes, and other stationary things. This is the first aid kit. I have two hand sanitizers, some crayons, which are nice because usually I don't have enough, and then some glue and the dismissal bands. And then I also picked up some of these bordettes, and I'm very lucky because my school does provide us with bordette. I did want to get brown, but I'm gonna have to do with green. So this is everything that I brought in. I am going to sit in my teacher table. After 3 years of teaching, I have learned that the first thing that you have to do, even before moving things around in your classroom, is make a plan. And because of moving, I didn't have time for that. So right now I'm going to make a list of the things that I want to do in order, and so that I have a really productive day today. I'm here from 8 until about 4, until I have to stay here to do my online class for my master's program. So I want to really make the most of it. So I'm going to make my plan right now. I have my to-do list ready to go, and I did also eat some breakfast. So first thing I'm gonna do is set up my desk area. I need to plug all the technology back in and all of that stuff, and then I'm going to move, and I might rearrange my furniture. If you knew from last year, I had my library over there, which I'm still gonna keep, and then my small group over here, and then a little calm down station over here. But I might not do that. I might do the small group over here, still have the library there, and then I'm not sure what to have here. Still deciding. We'll see what I do. But I do kind of want to get rid of this, so we'll see what I do. I'm gonna start working. This will take the longest, but let's do this. As you can tell, I got pretty hot, so I did have to take off my sweater, but I am in workout gear because I knew I would be sweating today. I have finished putting all of the furniture around my classroom, and I wanted something new, like I explained earlier, and I think I am really happy with the overall temporary layout of my classroom. I might change it, but to be honest, it looks pretty nice, and I have a really big space for the chairs and tables. So let me show you what I moved around. So the major change that I did was my library. I had this shelf over here and those two on this side before, and so I switched them around and I took out the carpet. As you saw, I was trying to use the gray ones that I had, but it was kind of limiting the space, and it was making everything kind of hard. So I just took it out completely, and I really like how it turned out. And then my small group table used to be here, but it kind of made the space over here kind of awkward. So I just moved my bookshelves that were used to be in the library over there, and then I moved the small group table here. And so I really like how this new layout is. We'll see how it works when the kids get here. But I also have those cushions that they can put there, and they could also just lay on them anywhere in this area when it's time to read. So that is my new layout right here. The next thing that I'm going to do in my classroom are my bulletin boards. And if you have been following me for the past 2 years that I have been in this classroom, you know that I have a leaf-themed classroom, and they were all inspired by the chandelier that I got from Michaels. And so I found this TPT alphabet poster, and I've been using it as the inspo for me to make other decor in my classroom. So for example, I have these titles on my bulletin boards that I made, and then I have other posters like color posters and 120 chart and number line. And so I'm going to be keeping these, but this year I decided to add a little bit more to my decor. So I am really influenced by the boho teacher on Instagram. Her style is so cute, and her classroom is so cute. And so I wanted to add some more boho-ness into my classroom, but not necessarily the rainbow theme. I don't want any other colors other than green, white, and brown. And so I'm planning on adding some some more natural looking things in my classroom, wood pieces and things like that. So stay tuned for my classroom tour to see how that ends up looking like in the end, but that is the plan. So I'm gonna do these bulletin boards and then we'll see what I do from there. These are what I'm adding to my bulletin boards and around my classroom. So I bought this on Amazon, as you saw in my summer haul. And if you haven't checked that out, then check it out. And then I'm gonna also add these bordettes just on the inside of this border. It is now 1:45 and I am starving. I have some In-N-Out for lunch today and I already actually ate lunch, so this is my snack. I had some eggs and some lentils, but I'm just eating this. I finally finished making that bulletin board in the back of my room, and then I also put up some leaves, and that's basically all I got done today. I am gonna do a few more things. I do have to be done by 4 because I have my class, but basically I have 2 hours and 15 minutes to do whatever I can before I start. So I'm just gonna take a break, check some things off of my notebook. And I think the next thing that I'm gonna do is probably put up my lights and chandelier, and that's probably all that I will get done today. It's now 4:20 and I have my class in 10 minutes, so I have to hop on super quick. But after I ate lunch, I did a few things. I put up my personal bulletin board over there, and then I put up the chandelier and lights, and I also cleared up the table, put those things away. And I am not going to work on my affirmation station yet because I'm not really sure if I like it, where I moved it. And I think that is everything that I did. I also put the water bottles under the sink. But yeah, that is basically everything that I got done today. I do have to go, so let me just show you really quick what it looks like in here. So this table is all cleared off. Here is the affirmation station. Like I mentioned, I'm not really sure if I like it where it is. So we will see. I'm holding off on putting those cards up. Then this part is done. Also, I wanted to know, how do you guys like my new bulletin borders? I'm not really sure if I really like the leaves, actually. So here is with it on. If you could help me out and let me know if I should keep the leaves or take them off. I did leave the one over there blank because I'm deciding, and I kind of just like the simple version better so that it's not too, I don't know, this is a little bit too much, but let me know what you think. And then I still have the borders over there. I put up those leaves like I mentioned, the chandelier, the lights, and I rolled out the carpet. I set up the desk. I do believe I always prepare for 20 students because I have about 20 each year. So I just need one more group of four that's gonna go in the middle. And yeah, this brings me back to a year ago when they were able to sit in teams. So I am still having to put up their dust shields. Right now in my county, everything is changing, and then starting tonight, they are requiring everybody vaccinated and not vaccinated to wear masks again. So they're still deciding on whether they were gonna require the kids to wear masks, but I'm not really sure what it's gonna look like. We might be even online, so this is just a setup of what I have. I wanna prepare for 20, and then I am putting up their dust shields because I'm very strict on cleanliness and just making sure that we are still being safe, basically, because this is still going on. So yeah, those are my dust setup. Then I think that's everything. I did put the bean bags over there. I'm still trying to get rid of them in the rug I want to get rid of, and then also my gray rugs that I purchased. But that is what the room is looking like. As you can tell, I still have much to do, so there will be a part two and more days of setting up my classroom. I am going to be into work starting Monday, so I'm sure I will be vlogging that day, but I hope you enjoyed this video enough to subscribe if you'd like to see how my room continues to be set up, and if you'd like to follow me on my journey as a now fourth year first grade teacher, go ahead and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.